Good evening and welcome to the Portland City Council meeting for June 12th, 2018. Please stand and join me for the Pledge of Allegiance, Lord's Prayer, and a moment of silence for anyone who serves in your service.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mrs. Pipley, will you please call the roll?
Jane Bielo.
Here.
Joel Friedman.
Present.
Beth Gilman.
Present.
Roseanne Hickman.
Here.
Brian Hill.
Here.
Margaret Phillips.
Present.
Lisa Sardi.
Present.
Thank you. Council, before you, you have the May 8th, 2018 City Council minutes for approval this evening. Do I have a motion as such? Mrs. Sardi, thank you. Is there a second? Call it verbal. Thank you, Mrs. Hickman. All those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Thank you, the minutes stand approved. Chair notes that certification has been received regarding rules of compliance in the calling of this meeting. We have no guest presentation this evening. We have one public comment. We have Rich Norgard. The floor is yours, sir.
Thank you. I just wanted to provide a quick update on the lighthouse. We kicked off our second tour season on May 25th officially. We're getting visitors from all over the state and from surrounding states. Quite remarkable, actually, the number of outside visitors we're getting. I think that's a good indication that where lighthouse is becoming getting on the map, as it were, and becoming better known among the general population. Our regular tour season will end Labor Day, but we're going to have a number of activities after that, and then we're also going to have our second annual Lighthouse Festival on August 4th, and we are hoping it will be bigger and better this year than it was last year, and it was a success. In terms of other activities, Main Street Port Clinton is putting on Walk the Light. You probably heard. It's got kind of a first of its kind thing. It's going to be a really big event. We are not directly sponsoring that, but it is using sort of the lighthouse as a centerpiece. We're going to have some fancy lighting that's going to make the lighthouse flash up, flash blue and green and orange and all these different colors while the acts are performing. I have a little bit of a concern about security for the lighthouse itself with the crowds, but that's something we're going to be working with Main Street on. But my concern is people are going to be tempted to climb up on the stones to see over the fence into the under the stage, so we may have to take some special procedures to measures. We'll see how that goes. They're going to be raffling off a guitar signed by Crystal Bar Sox, and the lighthouse will get the proceeds from that. I don't know if I'm going into too much detail here. We're also going to be open September 14th and 15th for the old class reunion, because there's invariably a number of classes that want to come to the lighthouse. So rather than just try to set specific times, we're just going to be open that weekend to accommodate anybody that's here for the union, reunion, that wants to see the lighthouse. There's also an event that the Ohio History people are sponsoring called Ohio Open Doors. And so a number of different historical sites around the state will be opening their doors free of charge to give tours and lectures on history. So we will be open September 16th, on Sunday, September 16th, from noon to 4, is our part of Ohio Open Doors. And then we'll be open again for the Marblehead Lighthouse Festival. So that's basically our schedule, in addition to 4th of July and Labor Day weekend. Regarding Lighthouse Park, as I just told Parks and Rec Committee, the boathouse is almost finished. We hope to have it out there by July 4th on site. Basically, the lighthouse is being built in two separate parts. We can't fit the whole structure in the building, so we're building the main structure separate from the roof. We're going to haul it out there in two parts. And Folk Construction is going to crane. Once we get it out there, Folk Construction will crane the roof on top of the house itself. And then as soon as Gail has driven the piles, we'll lift the lighthouse with a bigger crane and set it down on the piles, and it will then be in place. So that's how that's gonna happen. We don't have a date because we haven't heard from Gail to know when he's gonna drive piles. In terms of other activities that we have planned out there, we hope to start some of the landscaping, and we'll be working with the city on that, but hopefully as early as late July or August, we can maybe start moving some dirt to start some of the landscaping that we have planned, and then later we'll come walkways courtesy of Red Horse. So that's where we are. Any questions?
Thank you. Council, any questions?
I have a question and a thought. I really think this is a good thing to have this lighthouse at Waterworks Park. And I think it will draw people in as it has so far. And it's a good idea. All of you folks should be commended for what you have been doing.
Thank you. We're just proud to be a part of it.
It's very good to see you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Moving to the mayor's report. The mayor's absent this evening. Auditor's report, Mr. Hetko.
Thank you, Mr. President, pro tem. Council, before you, there are four separate ordinances. I apologize. Four separate ordinances in regards to general bond issuances. I know that we have talked about it in Finance Committee and as general, and council as in general as a whole. These bond issuances, I request be adopted this evening, if at all possible, only due to time sensitivity. Currently, we have a purchaser of all four bonds, and the term sheet for that bond expires at 5 p.m. tomorrow afternoon. If we do not adopt the ordinances, we'll have to reissue another term sheet, which will probably face higher interest rates. So right now, our interest rate that's been offered by the purchaser is locked in until tomorrow. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Hepburn. Council, I'll just piggyback on what he said. We discussed the bond ordinances, those four, the Finance Committee earlier today at 5:30. The committee recommended unanimously to approve those tonight as he requested. We discussed these, as he said, in earlier council meetings. I'm sorry, in earlier committee meetings, this is the first time we had the ordinances, but that's all aligned with what you've shared with us before, what has been our understanding. And I communicated that they would be requested to be passed tonight in his original email and my email to council this morning. So I don't think I received any other questions other than those that were asked at the committee meeting. We could discuss those at the time. Did I get that right? Okay. Cool. Thank you. Treasurer's report, Mrs. Hansen, welcome back.
Thank you. Bed taxes to date, $24,356.19. That's a nice number, but if you know someone that's renting out a room in their home, I just was told by tonight someone knew someone, please tell them to contact us or let me know, and I'll send them a letter saying, guess what, you have to pay 3% bed tax. because they should not get away free with that. Dark taxes to date, $8,134, and that's only three marinas that have paid. So we need to get pushing on some of these people that are not paying. It sounds good, but it could be a lot better. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Hanson. Law Director's report, Mr. Wilbur.
Nothing at this time, Mr. President.
Thank you. Safety Service Director's report, Mr. Martin.
Thank you, sir. Just a couple things. Do you have two items that before council tonight, resolution 182 to support a grant that we're pursuing to purchase carpet, replacement carpet for the senior center, and then ordinance to pursue bids for mill and fill for Fremont Road. The urgency for both of those are deadlines. The deadline for the grant falls between tonight's meeting and next week. The Fremont Road bid is already scheduled for advertising the 19th to 26th, with the bids being actually opened on July 5th. So that is why that is too time sensitive. Couple matters, just received the settlement papers with regard to 131 Madison. So we anticipate that the transfer of signing for that will take place sometime next week, early in the week. Just a reminder about brush pickup. This is the second Monday of each month. We are finished for this week. We have one, I believe, the fountains is left to pick up tomorrow, but we will be done for this this month. Waterworks Park walkway, I'm certain many people noticed that we did get, at least the festival area was sealed prior to the Walleye Festival, and we're working on that. We're finishing the sealing of the walkways very soon. Tomorrow and the rest of the week, if the weather permits. Just a reminder to folks about the ordinance regarding blowing grass into the streets. We get a lot of complaints. We get a lot of concerns and complaints regarding storm drains backing up. And that's the whole purpose for that. I'm concerned about the grass being blown into the streets. We'd ask folks to be a little more conscientious with the mow so that we don't have to police that. With regard to Madison Street, I'm certain you've seen a lot of activity in the last week or so. And that's just basically the replacement concrete. Cleaned and prepped and sealed as we near the end of that project. One last announcement with regard to the 4-hour parking zones that exist in North Madison and North Jefferson, likely affected this week as early as Friday. That's going to switch from 4-hour parking to 2-hour parking in North Jefferson and North Madison for a period of time. Okay. And I believe that's it.
Thank you. For the police chief's report, he's absent tonight. I understand the training. Fire chief is absent. For correspondence, we had Mr. Hatfield's month-end reports for May from the auditor's office, and a thank you card from Mrs. Hanson's family. Mrs. Sardi, yes.
That we accept the correspondence as presented.
Thank you. Is there a second? Thank you, Ms. Phillips. With a second. All those in favor, say aye.
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 Thank you. Correspondence is approved as stated. Moving to ordinances and resolutions, there are no third readings. Ordinances and resolutions tonight for second readings. Ordinances, resolutions. Mrs. Pepperly, will you please read by title and summary only, Ordinance 16-18.
Ordinance 16-18, an ordinance amending ordinance number 9-18 of the city of Fort Putnam and adjusting accounts within the city of Fort Putnam.
Thank you. Council, do you wish to take any action on ordinance 16-18? Seeing none, that will be moved to its third reading at the next council meeting, ordinance 16-18. Moving to new readings of ordinances and resolutions. Ms. Pebbley, would you please read by title and summary only, Resolution 18-2.
Resolution 18-2, a resolution in support of a grant application to the Ottawa Sandusky Center for Joint Solid Waste Management District and authorizing and directing the city administration to submit such application and declaring emergency.
Thank you. Council, do you wish to take any action on Resolution 18-2? Mrs. Starkey.
I move that we waive three required readings as to Resolution 18-2.
Thank you. Motion to waive three required readings. Do I have a second?
Second.
Thank you, Mrs. Gilman, with a second. Any discussion? I will add, we discussed this at the Finance Committee meeting earlier today at 5:30. And like the bond ordinances, we recommended approving this tonight, waiving the three required readings. Unanimously, 3-0. Any comments or questions, discussion? The clerk, please call the roll on waiving the three readings.
Kate Wheeler.
Yes.
Bill Friedman.
Yes.
Beth Gilman.
Yes.
Roseanne Hickman.
Yes.
Brian Hill.
Yes.
Margaret Phillips.
Yes.
Lisa Sardi.
Yes.
Thank you. The motion is approved. Council, do you wish to take any further action on Resolution 18-2? Mrs. Sardi.
I move that we retain the emergency clause as to Resolution 18-2.
Thank you. Motion on the floor to retain the emergency clause of Resolution 18-2. Is there a second? Thank you, Mr. Friedman, with a second. Any discussion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Lisa Sardi.
Yes.
Margaret Phillips.
Yes.
Brian Hill.
Yes.
Roseanne Hickman.
Yes.
Beth Gilman.
Yes.
Bill Friedman.
Yes.
Kate Wheeler.
Yes. Thank you. The emergency clause is retained on Resolution 18-2. Council, do you wish to take any further action on Resolution 18-2? Mrs. Sardi.
Mr. Vila, I move that we adopt Resolution 18-2.
There's a motion on the floor to adopt Resolution 18-2. Is there a second? Thank you, Mrs. Hickman, with a second. Any discussion? The clerk, please call the roll.
Kate Wheeler.
Yes.
Bill Friedman.
Yes.
Beth Gilman.
Yes.
Roseanne Hickman.
Yes.
Brian Hill.
Yes.
Margaret Phillips.
Yes.
Lisa Sardi.
Yes.
Thank you. Resolution 18-2 is adopted. Mrs. Pipley, will you please read by title and summary only Ordinance 18-18?
Ordinance 18-18, an ordinance providing for the issuance and sale of bonds in the maximum principal amount of $255,000 for the purpose of paying cost of improving real property to restore and preserve natural scenic or open conditions of land, water, or wetlands against modification or encroachment resulting from occupation, development, or other uses and declaring emergency.
Thank you. Council, do you wish to take any action on Ordinance 18-18?
Mr. President Pro Tem.
Mrs. Gilman.
I move we waive the three required readings.
Thank you. There's a motion on the floor to waive the three required readings on Ordinance 18-18. Is there a second? Thank you, Mrs. Sardi. I'll just recall for council everything I said earlier in email and what Mr. Hackett said earlier. Will the clerk please call the roll on waiving the three readings of Ordinance 18-18?
Kate Wheeler.
Yes.
Bill Friedman.
Yes.
Beth Gilman.
Yes.
Roseanne Hickman.
Yes.
Brian Hill.
Yes.
Margaret Phillips.
Yes.
Lisa Sardi.
Yes.
Thank you. The three required readings are retained, or waived on Ordinance 18-18. Council, do you wish to take any further action on Ordinance 18-18?
I move.
Mrs. Gilman.
I move we retain the emergency clause.
Motion on the floor to retain the emergency clause. Is there a second? Thank you, Mrs. Sardi. Discussion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Lisa Sardi.
Yes.
Margaret Phillips.
Yes.
Brian Hill.
Yes.
Roseanne Hickman.
Yes.
Beth Gilman.
Yes.
Bill Friedman.
Yes.
Kate Wheeler.
Yes. Thank you. The emergency clause is retained on Ordinance 18-18. Council, do you wish to take any further action on Ordinance 18-18? Ms. Phillips.
Mr. President Pro Tem, I move to adopt Ordinance 18-18.
Thank you. Motion on the floor to adopt Ordinance 18-18. Is there a second?
No, a second.
Thank you, Mrs. Sardi, with a second. Discussion? Seeing none, Mr. Friedman, I'm sorry. No?
No.
I'm tired today.
Forget it.
Thank you. Okay. Mrs. Pipley, will you please call the roll on adopting Ordinance Yes, 18.
Dave Bealow.
Yes.
Joel Friedman.
Yes.
Beth Gilman.
Yes.
Roseanne Hickman.
Yes.
Brian Hill.
Yes.
Margaret Phillips.
Yes.
Lisa Sardi.
Yes.
Thank you. Ordinance 1818 is approved. Mrs. Quabley, will you please read by title and summary only ordinance 1918?
Ordinance 19-18, ordinance providing for the issuance and sale of bonds in the maximum principal amount of $385,000 for the purpose of paying costs of improving the city's recreational facilities by constructing a walking path linking the city's waterfront and park facilities to its downtown declaring emergency.
Counsel, do you wish to take any action on ordinance 1918?
Mr. Bealow.
Mrs. Sardi.
I move that we waive the third and final readings as to ordinance 19-18.
I'll second.
Thank you, Mrs. Sardi. Motion, thank you, Mrs. Hickman, with a second. To waive the three required readings of ordinance 1918. Any discussion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Dave Bealow.
Yes.
Joel Friedman.
Yes.
Beth Gilman.
Yes.
Roseanne Hickman.
Yes.
Brian Hill.
Yes.
Margaret Phillips.
Yes.
Lisa Sardi.
Yes.
Thank you. The three readings are waived for ordinance 1918. Counsel, do you wish to take any further action on ordinance 1918? Mrs. Sardi.
I move that we retain the emergency clause as to ordinance 1918.
Motion on the floor to retain the emergency clause in ordinance 1918. Is there a second?
I will second.
Thank you, Mrs. Hickman, with a second. Any discussion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Lisa Sardi.
Yes.
Margaret Phillips.
Yes.
Brian Hill.
Yes.
Roseanne Hickman.
Yes.
Beth Gilman.
Yes.
Joel Friedman.
Yes.
Dave Bealow.
Yes. Thank you. The emergency clause is retained on ordinance 1918. Counsel, do you wish to take any further action on ordinance 1918? Ms. Phillips.
Mr. President, pro temp, I move that we adopt ordinance 1918.
Motion on the floor to adopt ordinance 1918. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Thank you, Mrs. Hickman, with a second. Any discussion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Dave Bealow.
Yes.
Joel Friedman.
Yes.
Beth Gilman.
Yes.
Roseanne Hickman.
Yes.
Brian Hill.
Yes.
Margaret Phillips.
Yes.
Lisa Sardi.
Yes.
Counsel, thank you. Ordinance 1918 is approved. Mrs. Quabley, will you please read by title and summary only ordinance 2018?
Ordinance 20-18, ordinance providing for the issuance and sale of bonds in the maximum principal amount of $400,000 for the purpose of paying costs of rehabilitating the city's water tower and declaring emergency.
Thank you. Counsel, do you wish to take any action on ordinance 2018? Mrs. Sardi.
I move that we retain, or I'm sorry, I move that we waive the three required readings as to ordinance 20-18.
Motion on the floor to waive the three readings of ordinance 2018. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Thank you, Mrs. Hickman, with a second. Any discussion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Dave Bealow.
Yes.
Joel Friedman.
Yes.
Beth Gilman.
Yes.
Roseanne Hickman.
Yes.
Brian Hill.
Yes.
Margaret Phillips.
Yes.
Lisa Sardi.
Yes.
Thank you. The three readings have been waived on ordinance 2018. Counsel, do you wish to take any further action on ordinance 2018? Mrs. Sardi.
I move that we retain the emergency clause as to ordinance number 20-18.
Motion on the floor to retain the emergency clause of ordinance 2018. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Thank you, Mr. Friedman, with a second. Any discussion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Lisa Sardi.
Yes.
Margaret Phillips.
Yes.
Brian Hill.
Yes.
Roseanne Hickman.
Yes.
Beth Gilman.
Yes.
Joel Friedman.
Yes.
Dave Bealow.
Yes. Thank you. The emergency clause is retained on ordinance 2018. Counsel, do you wish to take any further action on ordinance 2018? Ms. Phillips, with a close.
I move that we adopt ordinance 2018.
Motion on the floor to adopt ordinance 2018. Is there a second?
I will second.
Thank you, Mrs. Sardi, with a second. Any discussion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Dave Bealow.
Yes.
Joel Friedman.
Yes.
Beth Gilman.
Yes.
Roseanne Hickman.
Yes.
Brian Hill.
Yes.
Margaret Phillips.
Yes.
Lisa Sardi.
Yes.
Thank you. Ordinance 2018 is approved. Mrs. Pipley, will you please read by title and summary only ordinance 2118?
Ordinance 21-18, an ordinance providing for the issuance and sale of bonds in the maximum principal amount of $160,000 for the purpose of paying costs of reconstructing Jefferson Street, including improvements to related sanitary water and drainage facilities, and installing and improving sidewalks, landscaping, and declaring an emergency.
Thank you. Council, do you wish to take any action on ordinance 2118? Mrs. Sardi.
Mr. Vila, I move that we waive the three required readings as to ordinance 21-18.
Motion on the floor to waive the three readings of ordinance 2118. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Thank you, Mrs. Hickman, with the second. Any discussion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Gabe Velo?
Yes.
Joel Friedman?
Yes.
Beth Gilman?
Yes.
Roseanne Hickman?
Yes.
Brian Hill?
Yes.
Margaret Phillips?
Yes.
Lisa Sardi?
Yes.
Thank you. The three readings are waived on ordinance 2118. Council, wish to take any further action on ordinance 2118? Mrs. Sardi.
I move that we retain the emergency clause as to ordinance 21-18.
Motion on the floor to retain the emergency clause on ordinance 2118. Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you, Mrs. Friedman, with the second. Any discussion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Lisa Sardi?
Yes.
Margaret Phillips?
Yes.
Brian Hill?
Yes.
Roseanne Hickman?
Yes.
Beth Gilman?
Yes.
Joel Friedman?
Yes.
Gabe Velo?
Yes. Thank you. The emergency clause is retained on ordinance 2118. Council, do you wish to take any further action on ordinance 2118? Ms. Phillips.
Mr. Velo, I move to adopt ordinance 2118.
Motion to adopt ordinance 2118 on the floor. Is there a second?
I will second it.
Thank you, Mrs. Sardi. Any discussion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Gabe Velo?
Yes.
Joel Friedman?
Yes.
Beth Gilman?
Yes.
Roseanne Hickman?
Yes.
Brian Hill?
Yes.
Margaret Phillips?
Yes.
Lisa Sardi?
Yes.
Thank you. Ordinance 2118 is approved. Mrs. Pepperly, will you please read by title and summary only ordinance 2218?
Ordinance 22-18, an ordinance authorizing and directing the Director of Safety and Service to advertise for bids and enter into contracts for repaving and improvement of Fremont Road from the West Corporation line easterly to the West Right-of-Way line of Harrison Street and declaring an emergency.
Thank you. Council, do you wish to take any action on ordinance 2218? Mrs. Sardi.
Mr. Vila, I move that we waive the three required readings as to ordinance 22-18.
Motion on the floor to waive the three readings of ordinance 2218. Is there a second?
I'll second that.
Thank you, Mr. Freeman, with the second. Any discussion? Mrs. Sardi.
We did discuss this tonight at the infrastructure meeting, committee meeting, and as Mr. Martin explained earlier, it is time sensitive as they would like to advertise on June 19th, 26th, and the bids on July 5th. Which makes this time sensitive, and also the fact that we want to get this all done before the plant's close. There was a motion by Mr. Velo, seconded by Mr. Friedman, to recommend the full council to waive through prior readings, retain the emergency clause, and adopt ordinance 22-18 at tonight's meeting. Yes, 3-0.
Thank you, Mrs. Sardi. Any further discussion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll on waiving the three readings of ordinance 2218?
Gabe Velo?
Yes.
Joel Friedman?
Yes.
Beth Gilman?
Yes.
Roseanne Hickman?
Yes.
Brian Hill?
Yes.
Margaret Phillips?
Yes.
Lisa Sardi?
Yes.
Thank you. The three readings are waived. Ordinance 2218. Council, do you wish to take any further action on 2218? Mrs. Sardi.
Move that we retain the emergency clause as to ordinance 22-18.
Thank you. Motion on the floor to retain the emergency clause on ordinance 2218. Is there a second?
I'll second that.
Thank you, Mr. Friedman, with the second. Any discussion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Lisa Sardi?
Yes.
Margaret Phillips?
Yes.
Brian Hill?
Yes.
Roseanne Hickman?
Yes.
Beth Gilman?
Yes.
Joel Friedman?
Yes.
Gabe Velo?
Yes. Thank you. The emergency clause is retained on ordinance 2218. Council, do you wish to take any further action on ordinance 2218? Mr. Friedman.
I'll make a motion to adopt ordinance 2218.
Motion on the floor to adopt ordinance 2218. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Thank you, Mrs. Hickman. With a second. Any discussion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Kate Velo.
Yes.
Joel Friedman.
Yes.
Beth Gilman.
Yes.
Roseanne Hickman.
Yes.
Brian Hill.
Yes.
Margaret Phillips.
Yes.
Lisa Sardi.
Yes.
Thank you. Ordinance 2218 is approved. Moving to business from the floor, Mr. Hill.
I have nothing tonight. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. Hill. Mrs. Gilman.
Last night, the Strength of the Journey group had a board meeting. If you all remember, we had made Hamau our sister city in the Dominican Republic. Their delegation will be here in September, and specifically at council on September 11th, Tuesday evening, just to witness a council meeting. They will have translators with them. It's a group of 8 or 9 people that are coming to build relations. They'll be in the city throughout that week, and I imagine they'll meet close to people when they see these groups traveling around, which the large group will be about 18 people. So they'll do a lighthouse tour for the school, tour different facilities in our city. So I hope we give them a warm welcome. Also, the Sip and Chat that was hosted by the city with Mr. Martin there, I thought that was a great event I attended. It was nice to have that kind of access to administration. And this Saturday, June 16th, there's a movie under the stars at Waterworks Park at 9 p.m. The OttawaCountyArts.org website has more information on that. It should be a great time if people want to get out and attend it. It's about this can go, so just go attend it. Something new, 9 p.m. on Saturday night. And also Monday, June 25th, there's going to be 2 sessions about the opioid crisis. Sam Quinones will be here. The Ottawa County Prosecutor's Office is part of bringing him here. It's a free event. You can register to get tickets. There's 2 sessions at 10:30 and 1:30. I think it'd be great for anybody near to attend, and I encourage it. Thank you, Mr. President Pro Tem.
Thank you, Mrs. Gilman. Ms. Phillips.
Thank you, Mr. Velo. On June 19th, emergency services will be meeting at 5:30. I do have something to discuss with them. The second thing, CNBC has said that Fort Cliff is an excellent place to retire and identified us in the paper as that. It's really great. We have people coming in, we have people, full-time workers too, though, which is what we need for as well. I've had complaints about people putting grass down drains and as well as some garbage, but you got to catch them doing those things, or they'll say they didn't do it, so take care of that. I have been walking through the great field behind you, what would be 12th Street, at, south of us to the bypass. There are a lot of weeds there, the foxtails, but there's a whole lot of open land out there as well. It is drying. I think the fellow who's going to be planting out there is using what is known as tilling, no-till, where he will be turning over the dirt and putting his own seeds at the same time. So that's probably part of the slowness of getting that plot taken care of. I think that's about it. I do have to thank Mr. Martin, though. I received an email about something that was in 2 different parts of the city, so I just sent it on to Mr. Martin to figure out and straighten out the 2 homes regarding that. I don't know if he's completed it, but I don't need to worry about it. Now it's in his hands. Thank you, Mr. Velo.
Thank you, Ms. Phillips. Mrs. Hickman.
Tonight, Mr. President Pro Tem.
Thank you, Mr. Friedman. Mr. Friedman.
Nothing tonight, Mr. President Pro Tem.
Thank you. Thank you. You can call me Mr. Velo. This is Sardi.
Thank you. And tonight's Parks and Rec meeting, which we were considering, but it was discussed getting a selfie board, and there's a picture of it. They would like to see it. We discussed the placement, which would be at the city beach. Mr. Martin is going to follow through with that. There was a recommendation from our committee to do so. And I can't wait to see it out there. I'll let people start taking pictures. what your exact spot that you're thinking of, would you like to say? Or?
We're going to look at to the west of the west of the beach or east of the beach. Where the 2 large trees are, somewhere in that area. kind of pointing from us southwest to northeast, so that we can get the nor'easters that are kind of cut them out. That would be the desired location if it will take the weather okay. We'll see, but that's kind of the desired area. It's not going to obstruct any home, even during the place.
I do left and right, so that's why I wanted you to explain. Thank you. Also, as I said before, the city partnered with the schools and Clinton Athletic Boosters to do a BRPC summer kids camp for third, fourth, fifth graders to expose kids at a younger age to a lot of different sports. Lucas Kenny came and spoke. He's in charge of it. And the last the last booster meeting, he announced that he had a total of 80 students signed up. You have to be a Portland student. Even if you reside here, you have to attend the school. And Mr. Colson advised they had 40 kids there for this week because there was another camp going on, but I think that's great. I'm going to get these kids exposed. He's going to take, the head coaches have agreed to come and do an hour clinic for them, and then they break off into different things to get kids. They're going to do tennis, golf, they're going to do bowling one day, they've got the pool to swim in, baseball, softball, soccer, breaking off, you know, different things. So I think it's a good thing. It's a total of 6 weeks, starting Monday, runs for 3 weeks, takes the week before the July off, and starts back up for 3 weeks more. It is a 3-hour session. It's very exciting. I'm glad that they're doing this because, you know, all that kids, and it's good to get them exposure on their different things, because usually by the time they're in seventh and eighth grade, they've decided what they want to do. So thank you, city, for partnering. That's all.
Thank you, Mrs. Sardi. I have nothing tonight. Any members of the audience wish to speak? Seeing no further business.
Mr. Bealo, I move this August body adjourned.
Thank you, Ms. Phillips. Thank you. You started the second. All those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. We're adjourned.